Hi, I'm Chad, and today I'm going to be turning an end grain bowl out of this slice of cherry. It's about 5 inches thick. I'll probably use about half of it for the bowl. The other half will probably be waste. I'm going to mount it with a faceplate, and I'm going to attempt to use the Oneway Termite Tool. I've had this for a while, and I've practiced with it a little bit. It takes some practice. I'm not that great with it yet, but cherry is pretty forgiving wood, so I figured this would be a good project to try it again on. So for end grain bowls, I don't really have a process. I don't make a whole lot of them. And especially using the termite tool, I'm just kind of still figuring that out, as you can probably tell. What I'm going to do right now is shape the outside of the bowl a little bit and take off some of this bulk so I can increase the speed, because I think that'll help using that termite tool. And if I can't get that to work, I'll end up either using the a bowl gouge or a spindle gouge. they can give you pretty clean cuts on end grain, but the termite tool was made for end grain, so, and it gives a nice cut when I can get it to work, but, so I'm gonna take some of that bulk off and then move back around the front. The bowl is sanded to 320 grit now, and we're pretty much done. I'm going to cut it off of the little tenon here and let it dry for a few days. It does have this crack in it. I'm not too worried about that. It should be able to kind of flex and move, and I can always fill that crack with something down the road if I need to. So let's cut it off of here and get a better look at it. And the way that the sapwood here has this kind of reddish-brown color, you can feel how much moisture is actually in there, more so than the heartwood. So it'll probably take maybe 2 to 3 days for this to dry thoroughly. I'll give it a light sanding with some probably 400 grit, and that's probably where I'll stop it, and then a coat of oil to help bring out the cherry color. But the end grain bowls, they're fun to do because you can just slice off a log, throw it on the lathe, and turn. But they're a little trickier in that you can't necessarily approach them the way you do a traditional oriented bowl. I actually, on the outside, you know, a bowl gouge can be pretty good to get a smooth cut. The inside didn't give the smoothest cut, but you could see that I was still able to remove material. You know, you usually hear with end grain work from the inside out, which is, you know, typically what I do, but sometimes it works the other way as well. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. You can check out my social media at Chad Eames Woodworks on Facebook and Instagram. I'll put some finished pictures of this piece on there. And chadeameswoodworks.etsy.com if you want to check out my shop and see what I have available for sale. And chadeames.com is my website. All that info is down below in the description. I hope you enjoyed the project. I hope you'll subscribe and come back for the next one. Thanks for watching.